वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। आई एम मेघा। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कवर द टॉपिक जीन म्यूटेशन। इन पार्ट वन आई हैड कवर्ड क्रोमोसोमल म्यूटेशन, सो प्लीज़ लुक दैट ऑल्सो। नाउ लेट्स लर्न अबाउट जीन म्यूटेशन। इफ़ द म्यूटेशन इज टेकिंग प्लेस इन द जीन, ओके, इफ देयर इज अ चेंज इन द नाइट्रोजनस बेस, इफ दे आर एडेड, डिलीटेड और सब्स्टिट्यूटेड, दैन इट लीड्स टू जीन म्यूटेशन। Okay, so gene mutation are divided into three categories. They are substitution, deletion and insertion. Chromosomal mutation I had covered in part one. Okay, so let's see here. What is gene mutation? So there is a change in the genes, that is small section of DNA change. Now there are three types of gene mutation: substitution, insertion and deletion. In the substitution, one or more nitrogenous bases are changed with the others, okay, they are changed with the others. So it is divided into two, transition and transversion. Okay, substitution is divided into two, transition and transversion. In transition, purine is replaced by another purine or pyrimidine by pyrimidine. Okay, you know purine are adenine and guanine and pyrimidines are thymine and cytosine. Okay, so purine is replaced by purine or pyrimidine by pyrimidine, whereas in transversion a purine is replaced by pyrimidine. Okay, so this is about substitution, in which the nitrogenous bases are changed or replaced by another. If you talk about insertion, in this the bases are inserted or we can say added, whereas in deletion the bases are deleted or lost. So observe this figure. By this you can easily know what it is. This is the original sequence TGG CAG, okay, substitution, insertion and deletion. In substitution the bases are changed, okay, so you can see cytosine is replaced by thymine, whereas in insertion the bases are added. So you can see here TAT, this is the base sequence which is added, whereas in deletion the bases are deleted. Okay, simple. So this is about substitution, insertion and deletion. Now move on to the frame shift mutation. Frame shift mutation is due to insertion or deletion of the nitrogenous bases. Okay, look this figure here. This is the original DNA code or sequence CAT, which codes for the amino acid histidine. Okay, CAT codes for amino acid histidine. Now if suppose a single nucleotide is added, suppose this is added A here, okay, if there is a addition of a nucleotide, now you will see that the sequence are not divisible by 3 because a single base is added here. If suppose 3 are added, then they can be easily divisible by 3. So here you can see that only A is added, only a single base is added. It leads to the change in the reading frame of the message. After this, beyond this site, the whole message gets changed. Okay, now the ACA codon codes for threonine, whereas TCA codes for serine. So now the sequence gets changed, which leads to the change in the amino acids. Okay, this is about frame shift mutation. So we can say if the number of bases which are inserted or deleted is not divisible by 3, then it leads to frame shift mutation, because all the base triplets gets changed. Okay, now about point mutation. If there is a change in the single base, okay, if there is addition of single base or deletion or substitution, okay, if there, I am talking about single base, only one, then it is considered as point mutation. Whereas if it involves change in more than one nitrogenous pair, if more than one nitrogenous pair gets changed, then we call it a gross mutation. In point mutation, only one nitrogenous pair is changed. Point mutation are of three types: same sense, nonsense, or missense. senescence also called silent mutation because they are not observed. Nonsense and missense. Okay, senescence, nonsense and missense. Now look this figure here. You can see three types of point mutation: silent, also called senescence, then nonsense, and missense. This is the original sequence. TTC is the original sequence, which forms means we can say which transcribe to form mRNA AAGs, and it leads to a protein called lysine, amino acid called lysine. Okay, AAG translated to form lysine. Now if there is a silent mutation, then the amino acid which is formed, that is the same. AAG and AAA both forms the same amino acid, that is lysine. Now if we are talking about nonsense mutation, here there is a stop. In this case, the synthesis of the polypeptide chain gets stopped because a terminator codon has taken place. UAG, UAA and UGA. These three are the terminator codon. So here the synthesis of polypeptides gets stopped. In the missense mutation, there's a change in the codon which alters the specific amino acid. Here the amino acid gets changed. Okay, missense. The sense gets missed. So here the lysine is formed. Originally the lysine is formed, and in the missense case you will see the arginine and threonine, a different amino acid is formed. This is the missense mutation. Okay, silent, nonsense and missense. In the silent, the same amino acid is formed. In the nonsense, the polypeptide chain gets stopped, terminator codon comes, and in the missense, a different amino acid is formed, which may be non-functional. Okay, this is about the point mutation. Now here the question is, what is the relation between gene mutation and chromosomal mutation? So the answer is, the gene mutation result in chromosomal mutation, but the reverse is not possible. Okay, gene mutation result in chromosomal mutation, but the reverse is not possible, because if the chromosomal mutation are taking place, suppose we are talking about aneuploidy or polyploidy, in which the number of chromosome gets changed, okay, triploid, tetraploid condition is there. In that case, you can see that the sets of chromosome gets changed, so which cannot lead to gene mutation. Okay, so hope it is clear. Now, at what time the gene mutation occurs? So the answer is at the time of DNA replication. So during the DNA replication, if there is a change in any nitrogenous base pair, then it leads to gene mutation. It is also called copy error mutation. Hope you guys like my video. If you like it, please subscribe my channel. Thank you and have a nice day.